Hello everyone, this is Manisha Panda from Sambalpur, Odisha. I welcome you all again in my YouTube channel, that is Manisha's Magical Biology. And today we are going to discuss the microbes in household products. We are going to discuss the class 12th topic of the chapter Microbes in Human Welfare, that is microbes in household products. I am going to discuss about the what are the useful aspects of microbes in household. घर में microbes का क्या-क्या use होता है, that we are going to discuss today. Yes, I am definitely going to create the white magic today, as I have not wore the black today. I am wearing the white today, so definitely I am going to create the white magic. Although when I was wearing black, जब मैंने black भी पहना हुआ था, तब भी मैंने white magic ही create किया था. But now today, I am definitely going to create the white magic. Yes, I am going to create the white magic. Okay, let us start our white magic. Okay. So what is the useful aspect of microbes in household products? What are the useful aspects? First of all, I would like to discuss about the lactobacillus. I would like to discuss about the lactic acid bacteria, LAB. Lactic acid bacteria, I would be discussing about that. Curd. Curd, दही आप जानते हैं, curd is produced by lactobacillus. Curd is produced by lactobacillus delbrueckii. Yes, I'm starting them. This is the beginning of the description. Curd is produced by lactobacillus delbrueckii and other lactic acid bacteria which grow in milk. Curd is produced by lactobacillus delbrueckii and other lactic acid bacteria which grow in milk. Curd is produced by lactobacillus delbrueckii and other lactic acid bacteria which grow in milk. What are the useful aspects of this lactic acid bacteria? Lactic acid bacteria ka useful aspect kya kya hai? Curd kaun produce karta hai? Curd is produced by lactobacillus delbrueckii and other LAB. What is the full form of LAB? Lactic acid bacteria which actually grow in milk, jo ki milk mein grow karte hain. What are the useful aspects? What are the advantages of LAB? LAB ka advantages kya kya hai? There are three advantages given in NCERT. NCERT book mein teen advantages diya hai. So what are the advantages of LAB, lactic acid bacteria? First one advantage, LAB produce acids that coagulate and partially digest the milk protein casein. LAB produce acids that coagulate and partially digest the milk protein casein. Okay, first advantage is LAB produce acids that coagulate and partially digest the milk protein casein. Second one, LAB increase the nutritional quality of curd that finally increase the content of vitamin B12. LAB increase the nutritional quality of curd by increasing the content of vitamin B12. Okay, first, what are the first two advantages? First is LAB, lactic acid bacteria, LAB produce acids that coagulate and partially digest the milk protein casein. Second one, LAB increase the nutritional quality of curd that by increasing the content of vitamin B12. LAB produce acids that coagulate and partially digest the milk protein casein. LAB increase the nutritional quality of curd by increasing the content of vitamin B12. Third, in our stomach. हमारे पेट में, हमारे स्टोमैक में, इन अवर स्टोमैक, लैब चेक द ग्रोथ ऑफ डिजीज कॉजिंग माइक्रोब्स. ओके, सो लेट मी स्टार्ट वंस अगेन फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग. सो वी आर डिस्कस, व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ द टॉपिक? वी आर डिस्कसिंग द माइक्रोब्स इन हाउसहोल्ड प्रोडक्ट्स. कर्ड इज प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय लैक्टोबैसिलस एंड अदर लैक्टिक एसिड बैक्टीरिया. Curd is produced by lactobacillus delbrueckii and other lactic acid bacteria. What are the advantages of LAB? LAB advantages kya hai? LAB प्रोड्यूस एसिड्स, लैक्ट प्रोड्यूस एसिड्स दैट कोगुलेट एंड पार्शियली डाइजेस्ट द मिल्क प्रोटीन केसिन. व्हाट इज नेम ऑफ द मिल्क प्रोटीन केसिन. सेकंड एडवांटेज ऑफ लैब. सेकंड एडवांटेज, लैब इंक्रीज द न्यूट्रिशनल क्वालिटी ऑफ कर्ड. लैब इंक्रीज द न्यूट्रिशनल क्वालिटी ऑफ कर्ड बाय इंक्रीजिंग द कंटेंट ऑफ विटामिन बी ट्वेल्व. लैब इंक्रीज द न्यूट्रिशनल क्वालिटी ऑफ कर्ड बाय इंक्रीजिंग द कंटेंट ऑफ विटामिन बी ट्वेल्व. थर्ड, इन अवर स्टोमैक लैब चेक द ग्रोथ ऑफ डिजीज कॉजिंग माइक्रोब्स. लैब चेक द ग्रोथ ऑफ डिजीज कॉजिंग माइक्रोब्स. सो वंस अगेन आई एम रिपीटिंग द थ्री एडवांटेजेस. इट्स डन. यस. फर्स्ट, lab produce acids that coagulate and partially digest the milk protein casein. Second, lab increase the nutritional quality of curd by increasing the content of vitamin B12. Third, in our stomach lab check the growth of disease causing microbes. Okay, so this finishes about the Lactobacillus delbrueckii. Lactobacillus, what is the use, but how the curd is produced. We were discussing about the traditional, you can also say this as traditional biotechnology. This has been also compared with traditional biotechnology. Okay, so this was all about the production of the curd. Let us get back to fermentation process. Fermentation से क्या क्या produce होता है. Fermentation, आपके घर में मम्मी इडली बनाती होगी, इडली डोसा वड़ा ये सब बनता होगा. उड़द दाल से ये सब बनता है, इडली डोसा एंड ऑल दिस थिंग्स. सो हाउ दिस फर्मेंटेड, दैट इज एक्चुअली प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय फर्मेंटेशन प्रोसेस विद द हेल्प ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स, विद द हेल्प ऑफ माइक्रोब्स. The dough जो बनता है, the dough used for making idli and dosa. The dough used for making idli and dosa is fermented by bacteria. The dough used for making idli and dosa is fermented by bacteria. And the puffed up जो dough जो फूलता है, फूल जाता है जो dough. The puffed up appearance is due to the production of the carbon dioxide due to the fermentation process. The puffed up appearance is due to the production of the carbon dioxide during the fermentation process. Okay. The dough used for making idli and dosa is fermented by. The dough used for making idli and dosa is fermented by bacteria. The puffed up appearance is due to the production of carbon dioxide. During the fermentation process, the dough used for making idli and dosa is fermented by the bacteria. The puffed up appearance is due to the production of carbon dioxide during the fermentation process. Okay, what about the bread? Bread ka formation kaise hota hai? Remember, the dough used for making bread is fermented by the yeast. Saccharomyces cerevisiae. The dough used for making bread is fermented by the yeast. Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Saccharomyces. Ethanol ka production jisse hota hai. Saccharomyces cerevisiae. The dough used for making bread is fermented by the yeast. Saccharomyces cerevisiae. And it is commonly called as baker's yeast. Baker's yeast बोलते हैं उसको. The dough used for making bread is fermented by the yeast. Saccharomyces cerevisiae. The dough used for making yeast is fermented by the yeast. The dough used for making bread is fermented by the yeast. Saccharomyces cerevisiae, and which is commonly called as baker's yeast. Okay. So once again, repeating that about the dough. The dough used for making idli and dosa. The dough used for making idli and dosa is fermented by the bacteria. The dough used for making idli and dosa is fermented by the bacteria. The puffed up appearance is due to the production of carbon dioxide. The puffed up appearance is due to the production of the carbon dioxide during the fermentation process. The puffed up appearance is due to the production of the carbon dioxide. During the fermentation process. Coming to bread, the dough used for making bread जो बनता है, bread तो खाते होंगे आप. Bread मुझे बहुत पसंद है. I really love sandwiches. Yes, it's my favorite. Burgers I don't like much. Burger मुझे बहुत ज़्यादा पसंद नहीं है. Like sandwiches much more than burgers. Because it's very heavy burgers. Paneer sandwich. Yes. The dough used for making bread is fermented by the yeast. Saccharomyces cerevisiae, which is commonly called as baker's yeast. Okay. So once again, I'm repeating from the beginning. Curd is produced by Lactobacillus delbrueckii. Curd is produced by Lactobacillus delbrueckii and other lactic acid bacteria which grow in milk. What are the advantages of lactic acid bacteria? Advantages of lactic acid bacteria. First is lab produce acids that coagulate and partially digest the milk protein casein. Second advantage, lab increase the nutritional quality of curd by increasing the content of vitamin B12. Third, in our stomach, lab check the growth of disease causing microbes. So this finishes about the lab lactic acid bacteria. What about the dough? The dough used for making idli and dosa is fermented by the bacteria. The puffed up appearance is due to the production of the carbon dioxide during the fermentation process. The dough used for making bread is fermented by the yeast Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Commonly called as baker's yeast. Okay. Coming to some unusual uses. Okay. Have you heard toddy is a traditional South Indian drink. As you know, I love South Indian dishes. And though I've not drunk toddy, मैंने नहीं पिया है. But I've heard about it. Toddy is a traditional South Indian drink produced by fermenting sap from palms. Palm जो होता है, date palm का sap निकल के toddy का production किया जाता है. Toddy is a traditional South Indian drink produced by fermenting sap from palms. So that is all about toddy. T-O-D-D-Y, not T-E-D-D-Y. Teddy nahi, toddy. Toddy is a traditional South Indian drink produced by fermenting sap from palms. microbes. Microbes are also used to ferment. Microbes are also used to ferment fishes, bamboo shoots, and soya beans. Microbes are also used to ferment fishes, bamboo shoots, and soya beans by fermentation. Microbes to produce different food items. Microbes are also used to ferment fishes. Microbes are also used to ferment fishes, bamboo shoots, and soya beans. Microbes are also used to ferment fishes, bamboo shoots, and soya beans to produce different food items. Okay. So toddy is a traditional South Indian drink. Toddy is a traditional South Indian drink produced by fermenting saffron palms. Microbes are also used to ferment. Microbes are also used to ferment fishes, bamboo shoots, and soya beans to produce different food items. Microbes are also used to ferment fishes, bamboo shoots, produce different food items. Okay, so this was all about the other uses of microbes, like that of toddy, and the microbes are also used to fermentation of other food items, fermentation of other things like the fishes, bamboo shoots, and soya beans to produce different combinations of food items, a variety, diversity of food items. Okay, what about cheese? I love cheese. What about you people? Do you love cheese? ऐसा कौन होगा यार जिसको चीज़ पसंद नहीं होगा, ऐसा कोई है जिसको चीज़ पसंद नहीं होगा? थोड़ा बहुत था, थोड़ा कम ज़्यादा हो सकता है, बट देयर इज़ नोबडी. हाँ, मिल्क नेगेटिव पीपल मे नॉट लाइक चीज़, बट आई बिलीव डेफिनेटली पीपल लव चीज़. सैंडविचेस, बर्गर्स, पिज्ज़ा, पिज्जास, विदाउट चीज़ इज़ इट पॉसिबल टू ईट अ पिज्ज़ा? हैव यू एवर ईटन, कभी आपने पिज्ज़ा खाया है चीज़ के बिना? एक बार खा के देखिए, फिर जानेंगे कैसा होगा. सो चीज जो होता है, चीज पनीर इज कॉटेज चीज. पनीर को कॉटेज चीज बोलते हैं. पिज्जा में जो चीज यूज होता है, दैट इज मोजरेला चीज. पनीर इज कॉटेज चीज, कॉटेज चीज. पिज्जा में जो चीज यूज होता है, दैट इज मोजरेला चीज. There are different cheeses. Mayonnaise is different. Swiss cheese is one of Roquefort cheese. So there are different varieties of cheeses. So cheese ka production kaise hota hai? Cheese differs in texture, flavor, and taste. Cheese differs in texture, flavor, and taste depending upon the microbe used for fermentation. And or ripening. Cheese differs in texture, flavor, and taste, and depending upon the microbe used for fermentation and or ripening. Swiss cheese, first category. Two categories have been given. There is description of two cheeses given in NCERT. First, I'm describing the first one, Swiss cheese. Okay, Swiss cheese. Let me give the introduction of the Swiss cheese. Swiss cheese का introduction दे रही हूँ. Swiss cheese क्या होता है? Must have seen Tom and Jerry. Tom and Jerry is one of the favorite cartoons. आज भी देखते हैं लोग. आज भी आप लोग भी देखते होंगे. मुझे पता है आप लोग भी देखते हैं. Tom and Jerry में आपने देखा होगा ऐसा triangle type का triangle shape का चीज होता है. उसमें होल रहता है. वो ट्राइंगल शेप्ड चीज में जो होल्स रहता है, वो होल्स क्यों रहता है? व्हाट इज द रीजन बिहाइंड दैट? वो होल्स क्यों है? और वो ट्राइंगल शेप्ड चीज वो जो कि टॉम एंड जेरी कार्टून में होता है, टॉम एंड जेरी दैट इज कॉल्ड स्विस चीज, उसको स्विस चीज बोलते हैं. एंड स्विस चीज हैज लार्ज होल्स, स्विस चीज हैज लार्ज होल्स ड्यू टू द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड. स्विस चीज हैज लार्ज होल्स ड्यू टू द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड, ड्यू टू द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड बाय द बैक्टेरियम. What is the name of the bacterium? By the bacterium Propionibacterium sherman. Swiss cheese has large holes due to the production of large amount of carbon dioxide. Due to the production of large amount of carbon dioxide by the bacterium Propionibacterium sherman. Propionibacterium sherman. से मुझे शर्मन जोशी याद आता है. शर्मन जोशी, गोलमाल, गोलमाल वाला शर्मन जोशी. यस, सो स्विस चीज, स्विस चीज हैज लार्ज होल्स, स्विस चीज हैज लार्ज होल्स ड्यू टू द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड, ड्यू टू द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड बाय द बैक्टेरियम प्रोपियोनिबैक्टेरियम शर्मनी. स्विस चीज हैज लार्ज होल्स ड्यू टू द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड बाय द बैक्टेरियम Propionibacterium sherman. Okay. Second one, Roquefort cheese. Roquefort cheese is ripened by growing a specific fungus on it. What is the name of the fungus? The name of the fungus is Penicillium roqueforti. Roquefort cheese is ripened by growing a specific fungus on it. That is Penicillium roqueforti. So cheese, let me discuss about cheese. Let me finish the cheese part. Cheese differs in texture, flavor, and taste. Depending upon the microbe used for fermentation. Cheese differs in texture, flavor, and taste depending upon the microbe used for fermentation and/or ripening. Okay. दो चीज के बारे में डिस्क्रिप्शन दिया है. पहला है स्विस चीज. स्विस चीज हैज लार्ज होल्स ड्यू टू द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड बाय द बैक्टेरियम प्रोपियोनिबैक्टेरियम शर्मनी. सेकेंड वन, Roquefort cheese is ripened by growing a specific fungus on it. What is the name of the fungus? The name of the fungus is Penicillium roqueforti. Once again, I'm repeating about the totality and what are the other uses of microbes. The microbes used for production of different types of food items. Toddy is a traditional South Indian drink. Produced by fermenting sap from palms. Second one, microbes are also used to ferment fishes, bamboo shoots and soya beans. To produce different food items. Okay, bamboo shoots. I remember only the kaddi, that Odia word I remember. Sambalpuri word I don't remember the exactly what it is called in Hindi or whatever. Kaddi. What it is used. I must have heard. Okay, that Swiss cheese kis mein? Tom and Jerry. Tom and Jerry cartoon mein Swiss cheese aapne dekha hi hoga. Yes, aapne dekha hai. Okay. So, this finishes the content of this video. I hope you enjoyed the video, and we will meet soon again. There was a huge gap, students. I'm really sorry for that. There was a huge gap, and I really missed all of you people. I really missed you a lot, and I would definitely take care of that I won't allow you people to miss me again. Yes. Okay, have a good day.